Listen up. The rendezvous point is the shingle at the top of the beach. Use those defilades and keep moving. Do not stop until you reach the shingle. Clear the boat! Go! Go!
Oh!
going to need engineers to blow the wire! Get them to the shingle! Get those engineers out of there! That cutter's shot to hell! Engineers are moving!
Silence those 88s. Sergeant, round up your men.
All right, listen up. First squad, prepare to move out.
Dogfight is open! Abel, take that bunker!
job. One more to go.
We'll have him back to full strength in no time.
Excellent job, man. Sergeant Conti, get on the radio. Tell HQ our draw is clear for the tanks to come ashore.
Secure the perimeter and dig in. Inform Dog Company that we are in position and waiting for them to come offshore.
Men died that morning on that tiny strip of sand. Another 1,500 wounded, 300 missing, dragged under the waves. Pearson, Williams, Krasinski. All good men. By sunset, over 156,000 men had come ashore. The invasion had begun. Or, as my CO used to say, hell opened its gates. The night before, the largest airborne operation in history dropped three divisions of paratroopers behind enemy lines. And their objective was to seize major roadways and prevent a counterattack that could jeopardize the entire invasion. Success on D-Day depended entirely on these men.